Are Allbirds really the world's most comfortable sneaker? I wore them for a few weeks to try and find out. Allbirds is a pretty interesting company with a real big commitment to sustainability. Like the woolen upper here is sustainably sourced. The laces are made from recycled plastic bottles. The foam sole is made with castor oil, like sustainable castor oil instead of petroleum. And they seem to have really struck a chord with the market because they just launched a Kickstarter in 2014. And today they're valued at over $1 billion. It's not really a shoe for sneakerheads though. It's a really minimalistic look. There's no fancy designs on it. It's just like one big piece of wool stitched together at the back. It's really for people who just want like comfortable, soft, squishy shoes. And it's a favorite, especially among like the startup scene here in New York and out in San Francisco. And of course, worn by dads everywhere. The most interesting thing about the shoe is that it is made from wool in the upper. Let's take a closer look at it. So this shoe is called the Wool Runner. As the name states, the full outer construction for the Allbirds Wool Runner is composed of wool. That's New Zealand Merino wool. In fact, for this mode, which has fibers that are 20% the diameter of human hair, and it's breathable, temperature regulating, moisture wicking, not itchy, and it uses 60% less energy than materials used in typical synthetic shoes. It's ethically sourced as well from ZQ or ZQ Merino, who make sure the wool is ethically and sustainably sourced. The wool itself is then put through Allbirds' proprietary system and made into a material that is able to withstand everyday wear. It's very easy to wash. Also, the laces are made from recycled bottles, as I mentioned. And also, it is not very structured, this shoe. I have like this insert in here right now, but this is what it looks like normally. I've worn these for a couple of weeks and it does definitely deflate around the toe box, and that gets like more pronounced the longer you wear these shoes. So that is something to look out for, and it's one of the biggest complaints. I'm going into that a little bit later on in this video. Now the outsole, which is very dirty because I've been wearing these for a few weeks, is a very lightweight, low density foam. It's a rubber and foam polymer that's curved with what they call an S-curve to mimic the quote anatomical flexibility of your feet and give you some natural weight distribution as you stroll. One thing to note about the sole though is the heel to toe drop. Allbirds doesn't disclose the exact heel to toe drop on this model, but it is noticeable when wearing these shoes for a long duration of time. I noticed the drop pretty dramatically when walking downhill. It felt like my feet were kind of sliding forward and I experienced some toe jamming. It wasn't the biggest issue and shouldn't be a deterrent for purchasing this shoe, especially at this price and what the shoe is intended for. But it is something worth noting, and it really like lends to that notion that this is not really for very athletic endeavors. Because the wool has some give to it and the midsole has a big drop, you don't get the same like level of midfoot strap down support as you do with other sneakers. Finally, there's a padded insole on the inside, which is lined with merino wool to help with moisture wicking and odor reduction. Now, as for fit and sizing, you need to order large these shoes, and I mean like pretty large. I'm an 11 and a half normally, that's like my true size. I get a 12 with these and they're fine, but like my toes still kind of spill a little bit over onto the sides of it. It's not a big deal because like it's wool and it's pretty unstructured, like it's not very irritating, but if I could do it over again, I would get a size larger. But a real bummer with Allbirds is that they don't have half sizes. So I could only get like a size 13 if I wanted to go larger. And if I could do it over again, I probably wouldn't tie them really tight, but a 12 and a half would have been perfect, but they don't have half sizes. So that's a bit of a bummer if you have like feet like mine. I do wanna say though, it is pretty comfy. It's a pretty comfy shoe. It's very unstructured, as you can see. There are no stitches or anything on the inside to cause irritation, which is cool, which again lends to its ability to be worn without socks, controversially. And the sole is really nice and soft as well. I think it's a fine shoe. It's very comfortable, at least if you don't have foot issues. If you really need good arch support, you're gonna be out of luck. But you can always take out this insert and put in your own if you need orthotics. And I think that'll be fine as long as you order a bit big. But as far as the way they perform as sneakers, they really don't. These shoes are not for athletic endeavors. The arch support is not good. The ankle support is crummy. They are called wool runners, but I think it's because the wool is from New Zealand and in Australasia, where I'm from, we tend to call sneakers just runners, even if they're not used for running. Do not try and run in these shoes. And I knew that. I haven't really tried to work out in them, But even just walking around Brooklyn, like I've almost rolled my ankle a couple of times just by from regular walking because the sole is that soft and that squishy. It's a necessary flip side. That means it is not very stable. So when you compare that to something like the Chuck Taylor All-Star, that has like a very stable rubber base. It's a very low-tech shoe as well, but it's nice, it's flat, it's a lot more solid, and it's actually pretty good for doing like deadlifts and squats in. I would not recommend that at all for the wool runner. People are not far off the mark when they say it's like wearing a pair of slippers. And if that's what you want, it's totally fine. I mean, they are very comfy in that respect, but do not try and use them for any athletic endeavors. Now, as far as the price goes, a pair of Allbirds is going to run you about $95. So it's under $100. So, you know, it's pretty reasonably priced. It's a very minimalistic shoe, though. You know, you're just getting the woolen upper and the sole and the insert and the laces. I mean, I guess that's what most shoes are. But I can see people objecting to that price. I've seen plenty of people object to it. If you just like the look, if you just want a woolen upper shoe that looks similar to this, there are some knockoffs from Dr. Scholl and Urban Fox for under $50. But these competing brands, they don't have the same big commitment to sustainability. You're not getting laces made from recycled plastic bottles and so on. So I guess you're paying a little bit extra for that for a lower carbon footprint, if that's a priority for you. If not, there are some knockoffs out there, but they are pretty widely considered to be not quite as durable as these shoes. All right. Why should you consider getting a pair of Allbirds? I think the whole commitment to sustainability thing is pretty cool. I mean, laces from recycled plastic water bottles, it's a very, very interesting angle to the company. And I think it makes the shoes like kind of worth it relative to like a lot of their cheaper imitators. Like that whole ethos behind the brand of sustainability, I think that's very cool. It's also a pretty good travel shoe. This is an underrated component of the Allbirds shoe. It's really, really lightweight. You can easily fold it up and squish it into like a bag, which I've done a couple times myself. They fit pretty easily into a backpack. You can just mash them in there. It's not a big deal. I like that about the shoes. The sole, very nice and soft and squishy. It really is a lot like walking around in a pair of slippers, which, you know, has some downsides that I'm gonna get into. But if that's what you want, if you want a pair of sneakers that feels a lot like slippers, these will do the job. And they're made of wool, and the wool has a lot of upsides. Like, it's very easy to wash. It's temperature regulating as well. It's a bit antimicrobial. It helps with like wick away moisture as well. And also, I'm not a guy to wear sneakers without socks. I've never done it in my entire life until I got these shoes. Now, I wouldn't do it in the heat. I wouldn't do it today. But generally speaking, when I'm just like putting these on to go down to the shops or something like that, it's the first pair of shoes where I don't have to wear socks with. So I was pretty happy with that. But if you're not happy with the shoes, they've also got a money back guarantee after 30 days, no questions asked. So that's a really big upside as well, which makes it pretty easy to pull the trigger on these. There are a few downsides to Allbirds though. The biggest one is that they have no half sizes, which sucks. Like I definitely would have been happy with a 12.5. Instead I had to get a 12 and now my toes are kind of spilling out over the edge. Not a huge deal, but yeah, it doesn't look great when I'm wearing it. Really would have liked a 12.5. It's also not that water resistant. It's sort of marketed as being kind of water resistant because, you know, wool is like a natural material. It's helpful for sheep and stuff in the rain. But if you wear these in a downpour, you will get wet toes. I can tell you that from experience. Also, the toe box, probably the biggest complaint you hear out there. It does definitely deflate over time. And you can see some other older Allbirds out there where it's like even more dramatic than this. It does tend to wrinkle over time as well. Also, if you make a habit of wearing these without socks, there are a lot of reports out there that the material up against the toe box is easy to sort of like scratch up and damage from your toenails. And so people have definitely reported that getting less comfortable over time. If you're like really wearing them without socks a lot and you have kind of long toenails, but it is a risk. A lot of people have complained about that. I also wanted to say the last thing, they're not runners. They are called runners. Do not try and run on them. The base is nowhere near stable enough. There's not enough arch support. It's not the kind of base where you have like a stable foundation for like deadlifts or squats. I wouldn't wear them lifting weights either. The upper is not the kind of material that's gonna be useful for like athletic work, agility work, box jumps, that kind of stuff. Do not work out in these shoes. These are the kind of shoes that are meant to feel really, really comfy and a lot like sneakers and for walking around in. If that's what you wanna get them for, I think they're pretty good for that. Don't work out in them, but if you want shoes that feel like sneakers, slippers that is, they're very, very comfortable. All right, those are my thoughts on the very famous Allbirds Wool Runner. The full written review with a bunch of pictures and stuff is in the description below, along with some extra information that I just kind of forgot to say in this review. And make sure you subscribe as well, because I got a whole lot more shoe reviews and other fashion kind of stuff coming up.